Hey you guys, I feel like it's been forever since I have dropped a new video on. The sound equipment that I was previously using was driving me bonkers, and already, hopefully you guys can tell that the sound is so much better now. So give me one of those emojis, you know, the one that goes like raise the roof over here, if you are excited as I am for this new and improved video with sound. If you're new to my page, my name is Laura. I'm a certified personal trainer and Pilates instructor. Today, I am going to be bringing you a routine utilizing a foam roller. It does not have to look like mine, but you do have to be able to fit your bottom onto it. And I will, if you like this one, if you're like, that one looks fancy, then I'll go ahead and drop the link down in the description below so you can find one just like mine. Anyways, like I mentioned, we are going to be doing a hip opening using the foam roller. No, we are not going to be rolling out our hips. I'm going to be adapting a spine corrector series. If you're like, what's a spine corrector? It's a piece of Pilates equipment. Don't worry, we're using the foam roller. We are going to be doing a series to open up your hips, which is going to be amazing for after your runs, after long runs, and to also help you get into your glutes and your core. And why does that matter? I've said it before, but I'll say it again. When you are tight, it restricts you from accessing power that your muscles have. And of course, we want to utilize all the power, all the muscle energy that we have so that we can run strong, run faster, and also move about our day-to-day activities better as well. And it'll help you keep you injury free. So you can get down with all of that, and you're not already subscribed to my page, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and ring the bell. And let's go ahead, grab your foam roller. We're gonna start in that laying down position. I also wanna preface this with, if you have a neck injury, please circle with your doctor and see if you can do an inverted position. We are gonna be kind of in an upside down-ish position. So listen to your body. If you feel anything that feels just like off, please consult with your physician, your doctor. These are recommendations, not prescriptions for you. So just be mindful of that. We're gonna go ahead and put this foam roller on the floor. I'm gonna make it go horizontal ways. And then I'm gonna go ahead and loop my feet over it and lay down on the ground. Once I'm on the ground, I'm gonna go ahead and come up into a bridge position so that I can sit my tailbone on top of the roller. So already here in this position, it feels so nice. It's like an assisted bridge here. I can tell my hips have been tight from all the cardio that I've been doing, because already in this bridge, I can feel a nice opening through my right hip. So like I was mentioning, it's not on your butt cheeks. It's not on your lower back. It's on what we call the sacrum. So somewhere between that lower back and bottom cheeks. And from here, we're just gonna start with some marches. So one leg comes up to what's called a tabletop position, 90 degrees, and then lower it right back down. When you lower it down, press into the ground, find that stretch through the front of your thigh. And again, up into a tabletop position, we've switched legs, and then lower down. And I want you to notice here that as I lift up, I'm trying to keep my hips even on my foam roller. So I'm not swaying from side to side. You don't see my hip dipping to one side. Your hands also, notice that mine are cupped over the sides of my foam roller, or they could even go on top of the foam roller. On top of the foam roller is going to be a little bit more challenging because obviously you're not holding and supporting with your hands. So choose whichever feels good for you. I do kind of like this thumbs up position, not because I'm holding my foam roller, but because it helps me open up my shoulders more, and my posture is something that I am working on every single day here. Tight pecs over here. We're gonna do one more with the left side. And then from here, we're gonna move on. Now we're gonna have both legs up into what's called a tabletop position. Now, when we're up in this tabletop position, you should be able to balance here. If you feel like your legs went up and your belly went up and your back arch, then that lets me know that you should adjust your foam roller. You want to be able to feel like you're balancing securely. I could have my hands up and I really feel like I'm situated in this nice horizontal T position for the sacrum on the foam roller. Squeeze those legs together. Point your toes, and I want you to try to dip those toes into the pool of water, imaginary pool of water that's underneath us. And then I want you to lift your legs back up to table. And again, lower those toesies down. As you lower down, we're getting into that similar shape of our bridge, right? Lengthening through the thighs, lengthening through the hip flexors, and then lift right back up. Now, we're also trying to keep that foam roller from moving. A little bit of shifting is okay, but we definitely don't want it to slide from underneath us. Not only because, obviously, it would slide out from underneath us, but also because that would let us know that we're changing our pelvis orientation. We want to keep the tailbone heavy into the foam roller and try to keep it from going into what's called anterior or posterior. We want to keep it in the same position, neutral position. Last one here. And a lift. Awesome. Now we're going to take one of those legs back down, give it a little resty, and then straighten your opposite leg that stayed in the sky to the sky. Now, straight leg. Try to lift it perpendicular to the ground, straight up to the ceiling, and then lower it down, down, down to the ground. Aim for about even with your bent knee, and then use your abdominals to lift it right back up. And again, down, down, down. I squeeze my glute as my leg comes down. And because that booty is turned on, then it also helps me from arching my lower back. We're gonna do this 5 more times. You can grab onto your foam roller. You can push into the ground. You can take your hands on top of the foam roller, wherever you feel like you need to apply, have your hands to apply pressure to keep your shoulders in the floor instead of your head bone in the floor. Last one here. And then we're gonna switch legs. Whew, now my left leg's in the sky, have my pointed toe here. I lengthen the leg away from me. I think about reaching across the room instead of taking it downwards. And that toe print that paints the ceiling, finds the corner of the ceiling, and then goes down the wall, that helps me get a little bit more length into my leg versus downwards. If I just thought about dropping it down, that creates energy that wants to tilt my hips forward. My leg that's in the floor has energy in it, so I feel my footprint connected to that floor, and pressing that footprint down also helps me get a stretch through the stabilizing front of the hip as well. Last one here for 8. And then rest that foot down to the floor. Awesome job. Now we're gonna lift both legs up in the sky, if you can imagine it. I want you to have both legs straight up in the air, as straight as they can go. And from here, one leg will stay as the other leg drops down. So now we're kind of making this like V position with our legs. And I want them to cross paths. And now you're gonna have switched legs in terms of what's up to the sky and what's reaching across the room. And again, switch legs. So we call these ones scissors. And what I think is really cool about this exercise is that you can also see a lot of information about your legs here as well, right? When we're running, we want to have our knees, our ankle, our foot in line straight like railroad tracks, right? We don't want them turned out. We don't want them collapsing in. And so here we can see our knees, ankles, and toes, and we can see where our leg wants to turn. Are they straight like railroad tracks, or do they have the tendency to turn out and in? And then play around with how you could get the kneecap to be facing in line with the front of your ankle, and how you could play around with keeping the big toe in line with the pinky toe instead of turning in or turning out. One more down with my right leg, one more down with my left leg, whew, and then rest it down. So these can be a lot when you first start out with them. It takes time to be able to build up that connection into your bottom. I always like to tell my clients it's kind of like the road might be dusty in terms of your brain sending that signaling, sending that messaging to your muscles to be able to really feel that activation, that fire in them. So if you don't feel your bottom, give it some time, keep practicing it, and over time, as those hip flexors start to open up, and the more that you practice, you're gonna be able to feel it in your glutes, in that smile line of your booty. The next one and last one that we're gonna do is personally one of my favorites. It's called helicopter. Now, for our helicopter, we're gonna lift both legs up to the sky again, and we're gonna split them into our scissor kick. So we've got that V position, and then we're gonna trace them around a circle. So they go in opposite directions to make one big circle. Once again, I have one leg at 12 o'clock, one leg at 6 o'clock for my clock. They're gonna slice the clock in half, and then I'm gonna go around the circle again. Slice the clock in half, and then around the circle again. Whew. Slice and circle. So we're massaging out the hip joint, what's called the acetabulum. One more time this way. And then don't switch, don't slice the clock, just switch directions of your circle. So now we're moving in the opposite direction, switch the clock. You're still hugging that belly into your back without trying to flatten your back into the floor. There is gonna be some space there. Two. Last one. Bend your knees and then take your feet to the floor. To get out of this position, you're gonna lift your hips, slide that foam roller out from underneath your butt, push it away, and then rock on up. And there you go, you guys. That is a short little series adapted from the spine corrector, a piece of equipment that we use in Pilates. But you can also use your foam roller, just like we did, to get some nice juicy hip opening and some glute activation and some sneaky stabilizing core work. So for your core work, you don't always need that kind of burn feeling from crunches or even that burn feeling from planks. The subtleties of stabilizing your legs as your limbs are moving in space, that's gonna be so identical to how you are when you're running, right? When you're running, you don't actively feel the burning of your core. Similarly here, we're not actively feeling the burning of our core, but our legs are moving in space, similarly to how they would be moving as we run, as we hike, as we're climbing stairs, things like that. So just because it doesn't give you that fiery kind of burn doesn't mean that we can just throw it away and do it every once in a while. Super great to do it as a cool down, super great to do it as a recovery from a long run, or even on those days where a hip flexor is feeling really tight and kind of achy from a long day of sitting or a long day of traveling. That's when we want to be taking the time to work on our mobility so we don't compensate in what we like to do. That's all I have for you guys. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. It lets me know that you liked this video. Well, not just that you liked this video, but also lets me know that you would like to see more videos like this. And it also boosts it in the algorithm so that more people can find it, more people can find the benefits that I'm sharing. And I would really appreciate that because my goal is to help people be able to move injury free. That being said, if you're not subscribed to my page and you want to learn more about your body, more about how to move pain-free, how to reach your goals without having any aches and pains in your body, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so that we can keep learning and growing together. I'll see you guys next week. Have a good one.